Welcome to a new video of the Parts channel. Well, I'm going to make a short video answering a question that you have left me. Would a 200 cell catalytic converter pass the ITV test? Let's see. 200 cells would refers to cells per inch too. Normally the factory ones have 400, some have 500, 600, etc, etc. The engine. It is true that it is going to be more comfortable. It is also true that the engine is going to do more noise. There are people who do it, precisely, because they like it to make more noise, especially when they are reprogrammed, because of the backfiring and so on. But what I say, on the ITV they will not look if it has 400, 200 or 100 cells, which also exist. What happens is that you have more chances that they have you in the gas test. The first thing would have to be the engine. That is, the stoichiometric mixture. It would have to be perfect, and also, it has to be a 200 cell catalyst, but it has to be of quality. Okay, I'm telling you for the client before they are bought cheaply and end up being thrown away, and then, in the end, yes, they like how it sounds and everything else. But before going to the ITV, now they come with another catalytic converter, already in good condition, and of course that already leads to work to change it, between an hour and a half, 2 hours, and then when the ITV passes, they come back again. They put the 200 cell one back, and that in the end is a fortune. These 200 cell catalysts are good. They can cost from 500 euros, then. With the cheapest ones you can already have problems, because of course, the catalyst, the price, let's say, of the catalyst is determined by the precious metals it has, okay, to break down gases. The platinum, rhodium and palladium, okay, I don't know if I'll forget any more. Of course, nobody gives anything away. If it's a very cheap catalyst, maybe it has very little of these metals, also called noble metals, and of course, no does its job well and you could be fired. So let's see, my advice, if you want put one of these catalytic converters, my advice is that you buy it in a workshop that installs it for you and that has the gas machine, the same machine that the ITV has, precisely to give you a guarantee, that they are going to throw in the ITV when measuring those gases, too. I tell you one thing, those catalysts also last less time than the original ones, that is also clear, but as I say, if the catalyst is of quality and the stoichiometric mixture, it is also perfect in the engine, which is not usual, okay, of course, you could pass it, and if not, then they could throw you away, same quality catalyst, that is, in two vehicles, one was an Audi A4 1800 turbo gasoline and another rode a similar one, also of quality, in a Volkswagen. It was a Golf GT and it happened to the GT and instead they shot the other one. Well, here you have this video. If it has been useful to you, like it.